Hi all. Today let's take a look at one of the features in Angular CLI called the proxy configuration. This feature is really helpful during the development phase when we will be making calls to the server-side APIs which might be residing in a separate domain or on a separate port in the same localhost domain. For this purpose, today I have created two projects. One is a server-side application built using Express.js and other is an Angular application based on Angular 10. So let's first take a look at the server-side application. So here I have added two routes. One is the user's route and other is the profile route. So I have started the Express server and here the first API is users. It will return some data regarding the users and other is the profile. It is just a sample data for a single user. So the Express server is running on the localhost port 3001. And now let's go to our Angular application. So inside our Angular application, I have created a service. Inside the service, I will be making a call to the API users. So since we are running our Angular application in a different port, like it is running on 4200 in localhost, I need to explicitly give the domain for our API. So I have given for 3001 users and I am calling this within the app.component. Since I am returning a promise from the getUsers method, I am awaiting the result here and I am logging it in the console. So now let's go to our application and refresh it. Now you can see that the network call has been made to the server, but it returns an error called course. So now let's go to the console. You can see that the XML HTTP request from the 4200 port has been blocked by the course policy. So what is meant by the course policy? So course policy mainly means cross origins resource sharing. So this is a feature which is present in the browser. This is also called the same origin policy. So what does same origin policy mean? So it means that the browser has an inherent security protocol which follows that whenever a document or a script is loaded from a certain origin. So what constitutes an origin? So origin means it constitutes the host name, the port number and the protocol. So here the protocol will be HTTP and the host name is localhost and port is 4200. So all the JavaScript which is loaded in this particular origin will be able to access the resources only which is present in the same origin. So here, since we try to access the resource from a different origin, so if we go to this network, you can see that we are trying to use the same protocol and the same host name, but we are using a different port. So when we combine this, it becomes a different origin. So whenever we try to access a different origin or a cross origin, the browser will by default block it. So that's why we are getting this course policy error. So how can we overcome it? So the way which we can overcome this is like the server which we are trying to access is the localhost 3001. It has to send a header called the access control allow origin. So what it means is that the server is saying that all the origins which are mentioned within this header are allowed to access the content from this particular origin. So in case we had added this header in the response along with the value as localhost 4200, then we will be able to access that in the JavaScript. We can also give a value of star for the response header access control allow origin. So in this case, all the other domains will be able to access the content of this server. So this is not at all recommended in production environments, but for development, we can do that. So for achieving this, we need to go into the Express server and make a modification ourselves so that we can allow either all the domains or our current domain 4200, localhost 4200. But Angular provides an easier way making use of proxy servers. So what is a proxy server? So proxy server is an intermediate server which will be present in between the UI, that's browser, and the actual Express server. So in Angular, we have the inbuilt the Webpack dev server, which will act as a layer in between this. And what it does is it will be routing our API calls to the Express server. And while coming back, it will add the access control allow origin header also in the response so that the calls issue can be avoided. So now let's see how we can make use of the proxy configuration in Angular. So first, what we need to do is we need to remove the origin from the request, so I have removed it. Now let's go ahead and create a file called proxyconfig.json, and this is a JSON file. Inside that I am adding slash users, and here I am giving the target. So here the target value will be our target domain to which we need to make the API call, and we can give whether it is secure or not. So since we are using HTTP, we can make users secure false. So we can add the proxy config in two ways. So initially let's add it in the package.json. So in the package.json of our Angular application, we have the start command. So here I am adding an option called proxy config, and I am giving the path of our JSON file. Now we need to restart our application and run the npm start command. So our application is up and running. Now let's go to our application. You can see that there is no course error and we are able to access the data here. So now let's take a look at the second option which we can use for adding the proxy configuration. So now let's go to the angular.json file and we need to find the serp target. So one thing to note is that the proxy configuration works only in the serve mode, like in the build it won't be working. So now let's add the proxy config here inside the options, and here again we can give the same file name, the JSON file I'm adding here. So one advantage of using this is in the Angular JSON is that now we can run the ng serve command directly, no need to run the npm start. So now if we go to our application, you can see that again it's working as expected. Now why does the calls not happen? So what happens is if you go to the network API call and you check the response headers, you can see that the access control allow origin has been added along with the value star. So since this is a development mode, it is okay. Now let's take a look at some of the other options which are available in the proxy config. So one of the option is the change origin true. So this value needs to be used whenever we are making use of the target other than the local host. So in case we have hosted our API in a separate domain, then we need to provide the change origin true. So here, since I am using the local host itself, it is not needed. And some other options are like the path rewrite. So what happens is, like, suppose I need to rewrite the path, like whenever the user's API call is made, I need to call the profile API, I can make use of this one. So this is for path rewriting. And log level is basically for increasing the logging in the console. So you can see what is exactly happening and how the routing is working. So now let's again restart our application. So now you can see that additional information is getting logged in our console, like the proxy getting created, the rewrite rule created, and subscribing to proxy events and all those kind of things. And even when a particular API is hit, it will be logged in the console. So now let's go to our application and see. So here you can see that the users is the route which is getting called, but the data which is coming back is from the profile. So here in the console also it will be the same. So this is how the path rewrite works. So now let's see how we can handle multiple routes which needs to be handled in exactly the same way. So one option is like I can just repeat the same. So here in case of profile, so I am adding a new entry here. So I am adding it here, and I can remove the path rewrite. So this is one way in which we can use the same property for other paths. So since you can see most of the data is redundant here, so there is another option in which we can create a proxyconfig.js file. So let's create a JS file, and inside that module.exports, I can give an array, set that an object, and there is an option called context. Inside this, I can give the path. So here the users and the profile I can give, and I can copy the other details from the config.json and provide it here. So now let's go into the angular.json and rename it as .js and restart our application. So now let's go to our application and see whether the changes are getting affected. So you can see that now I am getting the response for the users, and in case I go to the service and change the path as profile and save it, now you can see that the profile is getting called. So this is how we can apply the same rules to multiple endpoints in the same target. Now let's take a look at one final option that is available in the JS. So that is called the bypass. So bypass option accepts a function in which we can access the request, the response, as well as the proxy options. So here in current example, what I am doing is in the response, I am setting the header as localhost 3001 instead of the star. So now we need to restart our application. So now let's go to our application. And let's go to the network tab and check the response and see whether it's affected. So in the header, now you can see that the access control origin is localhost 3001. So the bypass method will be useful for manipulating the request or the response. Hope you are able to get a clear understanding of the proxy configuration options that is available in Angular. See you soon. Thank you.